Out front tonight, Cheney versus Trump. The number three House Republican, Liz Cheney, is not backing down as Trump and his allies try to purge her from the GOP. Sources telling CNN that Cheney today met behind closed doors at a Republican conference and tore into the former president and his lies about the election, saying, quote, "We can't be a cult of personality. We can't whitewash what happened on January 6th or perpetuate Trump's big lie. It is a threat to democracy. What he did on January 6th is a line that cannot be crossed." These are simple facts, but it is a stunning remark coming from the highest-ranking Republican woman in the House. And just by saying those facts, she could lose her leadership position, at the least. A senior House Republican telling CNN that Cheney could lose a vote and be kicked out of leadership because she continues to take on Trump. Her comments have left the House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, quote, furious at Cheney, according to just one source. Well, Cheney earlier today came out on Twitter saying the 2020 presidential election was not stolen. Anyone who claims it is was spreading the big lie, turning their back on the rule of law and poisoning our democratic system. Anyone who is, well, right now, that person is the former president, because he put out a statement just this morning. This is what she was responding to. He said, the fraudulent presidential election of 2020 will be, from this day forth, known as, caps, the big lie. I just want to call out here just something really simple, having known Trump for 20 years. He is doing what he has succeeded at doing his whole life, projecting his own reality onto others. Because, of course, he knows that the words, the big lie, have come to refer to Trump's lie that the election was stolen. So he's going to try to appropriate them, trying to create confusion, to turn the tables. And he didn't stop there. This afternoon, he released another statement calling Cheney a warmonger, claiming she'll never run in a Wyoming election again, taking her on yet again for telling the truth.
There really was the president and many around him pushed this idea that the election had been stolen. And that is a dangerous claim. It wasn't true.
The election wasn't stolen. The notion that the election had been stolen or that the election was rigged was a lie. And people need to understand that.
These are basic facts. And yet Republican Congressman Anthony Gonzalez tells CNN, I quote him, if a prerequisite for leading our conference is lying to our voters, then Liz is not the best fit. And Cheney is not the only one under attack. This was the response when Mitt Romney, who voted to impeach Trump, brought up the former president while speaking to Republicans in his own state.
I don't hide the fact that I wasn't a fan of our last president's character issues. And I'm also no fan.
That's the senator who received an overwhelming 63% of the vote in 2018. And, of course, on cue, in a statement today, Trump comes out and calls Romney a stone-cold loser. Again, not to get technical, but of course the only loser here technically was Donald Trump. And yet the Republican Party has chosen which way it will go. I mean, if you just look at the National Republican Congressional Committee, you'll see it. That's the fundraising arm for congressional races, right? So that's mainstream, right? They're funding all the races out there coming into the midterms. They're now taking on the leadership of their own party. Here's the fundraising email. In part, quote, attacks on patriots like President Trump are at an all-time high. Now, just to be very clear, right, the definition of a patriot would be someone who fights to maintain democracy, not to undermine it, which, of course, is what Trump has been doing by perpetuating this lie again and again, whether it was today's statement or this recent rant. This was just the other day, hanging out in the patio at Mar-a-Lago, where he was putting out claims about, well, all kinds of states that he says he won, but he lost, including Arizona.
Let's see what they find. I wouldn't be surprised if they found thousands and thousands and thousands of votes. So we're going to watch that very closely. And after that, you'll watch Pennsylvania and you'll watch Georgia and you're going to watch Michigan and Wisconsin and you're watching New Hampshire. They found a lot of votes up in New Hampshire just now. You saw that because this was a rigged election.
This is just the other day. Don DeSuit went out and said that, saying the exact same things that he said in November, a full 6 months ago. I mean, you literally could look at that Wednesday and go, oh, was that timestamped November or December? No, it was timestamped last week. So in a moment, I'm going to talk to a Republican Georgian election official who was censured by his own party. That official joins the growing list of Republicans that the GOP is trying to expel from the party. And if you thought after all this, you have heard it all, I will present to you this, a quote from a Republican organizer in Michigan who is trying to oust the state's executive director of the GOP because that director said, and I quote, the election wasn't stolen. So that's grounds to get, you know, ejected. Deborah L. telling the Washington Post, quote, I speak for many people in that Trump has never actually been wrong. And so we've learned to trust when he says something. that he's not just going to spew something out there that's wrong and not verified. For real?
Then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning?
I don't put that out there to be funny. I just put it out there to show you how literally this is what he does. His entire brand, his entire persona, right, is about hyperbole, exaggeration, and spewing things that are wrong and not verified. That is the Trump brand. But now those lies are becoming a threat to American democracy because people actually believe what he's saying. Manu Raju is out front live on Capitol Hill. And Manu, you've been talking to Republicans on the Hill all day as Liz Cheney has been standing up for right against what the president is now continuing to put out there, the lie about the election. Where does Liz Cheney stand right now?
She's on very shaky ground internally, and there's still an open question about whether she can hang on in that number three post in leadership. Remember, back in February, she faced down the threat to her leadership post in the aftermath of her joining 9 other House Republicans to vote to impeach Donald Trump on a charge of inciting the January 6th insurrection. At that time, the House Republican leader, Kevin McCarthy, he told his conference behind closed doors to give him the leadership team he needs to lead the Republicans back to the majority. Then the Republicans voted overwhelmingly to support her to stay in the post. Things have changed, according to multiple Republicans that I have spoken to. The opposition has grown beyond the most conservative wing of the Republican Conference, the House Freedom Caucus, to other elements of the Republican Conference as well. People who support her have told me that they don't know if they could support her again because, in their view, they believe that her comments against Trump will hurt their ability to unify ahead of the 2022 midterms. Kevin McCarthy has tried to align himself with Trump, reversing his criticism that he had issued on Donald Trump in the aftermath of January 6th, instead trying to bring Trump into the fold to help Republicans win back the majority. But McCarthy has not said whether or not he will stand behind Cheney. His allies have called for her ouster, and what McCarthy can do is significant because he has the power to call for a snap election that could happen as soon as next week, and it's uncertain ultimately what he will do. So all eyes are on him, but as we're hearing from a number of Republicans, pressure is growing on her and him to make a decision here. But it's a secret ballot election, Erin. So if and when this time comes, it's still an open question about whether she can hang on.